Katrina Cross, the housekeeping manager at Wascana Rehab Center. With me is Gail,
Hi.
Clarence, and Jane.
Hello.
Hi.
And this is our linen supply room where we keep all of our carts and our linen supplies. And we have had a change with our lean process and our exchange carts, which has been very successful for us here. As you can see, the carts behind us are now, these carts are ready to go for the weekend. They've been nicely labeled for each individual unit, which we never had before. And each cart is tailor-made to the specific unit, which has been a huge win for us, because in the past, we had just a generic cart, and often our poor linen people would be running all over this facility because they'd be getting a million phone calls.
Yep.
We're missing this item, we're missing that item, and you just felt like all you were ever doing is running and chasing your tail. So this has definitely eliminated a lot of that and cleaned up our process. As you can see, there's items behind me here. We did have a little bit of a glitch in our system today, nothing to do with the linen. It was actually our delivery docks were going to be closed down due to some service in our facility. So we had to work with hospital laundry to give us some extra items in case we weren't able to access our loading dock and get our carts today. So thanks to them, we were able to do that. But normally, this does not exist anymore. We no longer keep supply on hand. It's just in and out and brought back. What else should we share?
So explain a little bit about, you know, how you fill the carts, stuff the carts, or
we don't fill the carts.
Oh,
they come full.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
from hospital
we just basically take them from our dock, bring them down, and bring them in here, and then they're ready to go for the next morning.
So explain that process. So pretend it's 7 o'clock in the morning now.
Oh, okay. So at 7 o'clock in the morning, you grab your two carts for let's say 3-6, take off to 3-6, and just basically exchange. So where one cubby has got a 3-6 cart that was used the day before, you take that out, put a fresh one in, one of these ones in, and go to the other side and do the same with the other one.
Right.
So it's two full carts per ward.
And then bring the empty one down here?
Yep, we bring the empty ones down and they go straight back to hospital laundry so that they can refill them again.
So what's the turnaround time?
A day.
Yeah,
one
a day.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It works awesome. I mean, it was hard to get started at first, but I think it works awesome for us now.
Yeah.
We're so used to doing it, so the weekend works good for you guys.
Oh, and
Yeah.
They're on time. There's a regular set time. You know, they're not always rushing around if they're running out of laundry or
they have the odd day where it's not working.
Yeah, but not very often.
Yeah.
So how did this happen? I mean, that you switched to this method?
It was driven by hospital laundry services. Wascana Rehab Center was using a different system than the acute sites, which was problematic. We needed to all be consistent. So we also know that we are losing our hospital laundry services and moving towards Cabro. So it was inevitable that we would have to make the change. So to transition easier from our old system to the new system, it was decided that we would start here, get us switched over, changed over, so when Cabro comes on board, really it's just a simple transition. We're really probably not going to even notice any changes whatsoever. We've kind of worked out all the kinks and the bugs and all that stuff in advance, and have really done a lot of work with hospital laundry and our linen coordinator to make sure our carts are maintaining properly, and if there's any changes, we deal with them immediately. So
is this part of Kanban implementation?
Slightly. I think there was a little bit of Kanban methodology used in it. So, yeah, that was definitely a part of it.
Was it part of an RPIW?
Yes, we did do an RPIW. And some value stream mapping. We did a week RPIW with the lean people, hospital laundry services, ourselves. We worked with two specific units to trial this on to get it up and running, which was 2-5 and 3-5. Once we were successful there, we rolled it out to the rest of the facility and replicated it and used our learnings from those two departments to get us tweaked, and it's running well. We also use the cart covers. So the plastic that you can see stays on the carts. So what happens when the staff will deliver the carts to the unit? They will just lift up the front of it and put it on top. The staff will take what they need from it. The next day when they come to remove the cart, The next day, they will pull the plastic back down, so it would be put up like this. You get the idea. And then when they come to retrieve the cart the next day, they pull the plastic down to protect all the items in it. This is removed, brought back down, and then this cart's returned to Hospital Laundry Services to be replenished and returned to us.
So what are this? Must be some savings in terms of time and et cetera?
Absolutely. And I'm sorry. Yeah. You want to talk about
maybe? Absolutely.
Yeah.
It's no, we're not getting constant calls anymore to rush upstairs, deliver this because they ran out of this or that or anything like that. It's whatever they have on the floor, they use, and they've always got extras. So
it's eliminated waste.
It's eliminated waste, yeah.
Yeah. Any comments?
For you?
Yeah, I just find it way more efficient than it was before. Like she said, we don't have to run around the building all over looking for this and that. And if we don't have it, then they don't get it. And yeah, it's way better.
I never did the old way they did the linen. Like I started when they started this, so I have nothing really to compare it to. Yes.
Yeah.
It works good.
Well, really fantastic. A team effort, right?
Oh, this is, we would never be successful if it wasn't for our team. They're the reason why we're here. They're the meat in our sandwich. They're the ones with the knowledge, and they're out in the floors. They know the needs of the people. They're the ones who the nursing unit staff will poke on the shoulder and say, we need this, we need that. So they're our direct link to the units, and that information was very valuable in our process. So we heard from that side of the fence what were some of the concerns and issues that we had to address, and we would have never had that knowledge without their relationships with those folks.
Well, congratulations. That's fantastic.
Thank you.
Thank you. It's worked well.